season 1, episode 2, KM 2024, when it was free.
Yeah, I heard them dogs barking. I wanted to see what that was. Remember when you ran just for the freedom of it? Back when it was free, if your cousin outran you that day, y'all go line up again until you beat him.
Here and I can put back. Mm-hmm.
But back when it was free, we did it all day. Wait a minute, let's do it again. He take off his cap. Because the cap fell off when y'all took off. Now let's do it again. He hiked up his pants. Let's fix his socks, get them situated. So you just keep coming till you beat him. Or you figure out another way. After y'all get through running the official races, y'all walking home. Y'all walking home side by side talking. Then you take off. First one to the step win. You beat him. You good for the day.
I'm sure how to do it, man. Watch us do
it. Well, I wasn't running my fastest. And although we study running when we're not actually running, every time you hit the ground, your foot hit the ground, how much force you think's been applied to the ground. Do you think that's 90 pounds?
Yeah.
No. Some more. Because of the explosion of jumping up and coming back down. The point is, you're putting more pressure on the ground, right? And that's to make you propel yourself even further. Every time I hit the ground, there's more pressure on the ground, right?
Yeah.
The more pressure I'm putting on the ground. And all that energy, once you hit the ground, and this ground doesn't give way, does it? The sidewalk?
No.
Where do you think that energy goes back to? Goes back up into your body. So that's why we don't like running on hard surfaces. Though running is a big part of her life, when I think about it, that's no more than about 2 to 3 hours a day on average. Not a whole bunch of her life is spent running.
Okay, turn around, Demonte. Get back in there, Johnny. Don't cover him up right there. Stop.
He's running off.
Her life is spent being free. The freedom to decide. The freedom to plan. Plan the future that she wants. The freedom to do the things that she enjoys.
Oh, you mean push your leg.
Yes, we do. Demonte, let Journey on there real quick.
I'll push Journey.
No, no, move. Bring back memories.
And that is a privilege that our parents have done everything in their power to provide and to put her in a position where she have the freedom to do whatever it is that she wants to do. Coming at you that way.
She's coming right?
She's gonna be coming at you that way.
Okay. We are all on a path. Maybe we didn't choose the path, but what we can choose is how to walk it gracefully, how to run it gracefully, and how to have the Lord on your side. When we're on our path, we have to choose how we're going to react to those on our path. Are we going to run into them? Are we going to let them stand in our way? But there are times that our paths intersect. Times that they don't. We have to choose our path. We have to choose how we react to our path. We have to choose how we're going to run on our path.
So I think as a parent, it's important that she see me being successful in the things that I endeavor to do. So that's why right there, to be quite honest, my back is hurting so bad at the end right there. I wanted to just stop, but I saw her coming. I said, nah, I want her to see me pushing through. Training should never be a roadblock. Getting the opportunity to train, especially when you have a flexible schedule. You can never say, I didn't have time to train. Nutrition should never be a roadblock when you can afford to buy quality foods. And she has a budget for that. Her mom and I have made sure that, you know, when we decided that we're all in and that she is something special, we're going to put that in our budget for her to make sure that she eats properly. So that's no excuse. You know, when you have the funds, nutrition shouldn't be an excuse. Training shouldn't be an excuse. Getting enough sleep shouldn't be an excuse. Knowing your sport shouldn't be an excuse. So I think I listed quite a few there. So for her, she's out of excuses. We're going to give them, but we're not going to accept them. I want her to start to think of herself as special. Not now uppity or anything like that, but okay, you're not going to be running around outside with your shoes off. Don't let people be running trying to, you know, your kids your age, trying to run and pick you up and dropping and playing like that. You know, you got something you're trying to do. Well, that's to become an Olympian, which requires all the work that it takes to put into a person to become that, and then being blessed for that to happen. There's a lot of people that want to be Olympians, but when she's on the trail, when she's running, she's free to think about all that. Everything's about becoming the best runner, but that's what running is about, freedom. And when we lose sight of that, we lose sight of the big picture. Back when they were kids, they did it all for fun and the freedom of it. And it's important that that application is always running in her mind if she's going to become the best runner ever. That's a runner's life. Krianne McBride, 2024.